Hello, thank you very much for joining me here today. Today I'm going to be talking about the five most common nutritional deficiencies in vegans and how you can overcome them. Vegan diet is generally a plant-based diet that comes along with many, many health benefits as it is rich in fiber. And if you're a whole food vegan on a whole food vegan diet, then you also have a lot of nutrients in your diet and it is very low in unhealthy saturated fats. Now, vegans are also less likely to develop cancer than people who eat meat. And vegans have a lowered risk for osteoporosis, high blood pressure, and heart disease, as well as type 2 diabetes. So overall, it is a healthy diet. Also, a change to this type of diet can help reverse type 2 diabetes and many heart disease and different types of cancer as well. However, there are some health risks that you want to watch out for, especially if you're starting out on a vegan diet without the right knowledge. Otherwise, you may risk not consuming adequate amounts of critical nutrients that are very important to your health and your livelihood. So here are five nutritional deficiencies that may arise in a vegan diet. The first one is vitamin A. Vitamin A is needed for healthy skin, mucous membranes, a robust immune system, good eye health, and for vision. Very important also for embryonic cells and for red blood cells and many, many more cells in the body. Now, beta carotene is the inactive precursor, which is converted in the body into the active form of vitamin A called retinol. Now, as a vegan, the primary source of vitamin A is beta carotene since we consume no animal product, and beta carotene is very rich in most vegan diets as it is very abundant in many plant foods. However, genes play a significant role in how we perform this conversion from beta carotene to vitamin A. Now, a 2008 study shows that a difference in a single nucleotide of the DNA can control a person's conversion rate of beta carotene to vitamin A, and people, including myself, with this common specific genetic variation will have a decreased conversion of beta carotene to retinol by almost 70%. And for other people with a less common gene variation, they will have a decreased conversion of beta carotene to retinol by 32%. So this is very, very critical. More than half of the population have this gene variation that they won't be able to convert very well beta carotene to retinol. Now, this conversion also requires bile salts, which are produced in the liver, so you need a healthy liver, and this happens when you consume fat. And we need about 6 times as much beta carotene to equal the amount of vitamin A. So, if you don't convert beta carotene into retinol very efficiently, like me, then you will become deficient and you will need to supplement your diet with vitamin A on a regular basis so long as you are a vegan. However, beware of excessive vitamin A supplementation as vitamin A is a fat-soluble vitamin and it can build up in the body and become toxic with time. So vitamin supplements that offer vitamin A, they have about 10,000 international units, IU, which is a little over the daily recommended limit for vitamin A, and which is 3 milligrams per day. So if as a vegan you suffer from skin disorders or have night blindness, and sometimes dental caries are also a sign that you may be converting beta carotene to retinol not very efficiently, and then I would recommend supplementing with this type of vitamin A supplement 2 to 3 times per week. And also for small vegan children who are poor converters, then you may wish to supplement them once or twice a week depending on their age. And to determine if you have a poor conversion rate, you may wish to do some genetic testing for these specific SNPs in the BCMO1 gene. Now, the next vitamin deficiency that is common among vegans is vitamin B12. Naturally occurring vitamin B12 is synthesized, made by bacteria, and it is therefore found in areas of bacterial growth. It is therefore found in animal products and in the dirt and soil. And so some freshly picked foods may have a little bit of this vitamin. But and also fortified foods that have this, may have this vitamin, such as nutritional yeast and plant milks, different types of plant milks. But vegan supplementation is definitely recommended, and a regular blood test can show you your levels to determine at what rate you should be supplementing your diet with this vitamin. I recommend supplementing with the B12 form of that's known as methylcobalamin. It's with a methyl group. Now, low levels of B12 will lead to anemia, immune system disorders, weakness, fatigue, heart palpitations as well, shortness of breath, loss of appetite, and nervous disorders, as well as loss of vision as well. So it is wise to control and maintain sufficient levels of this vitamin regularly. Now, the next vitamin that is also sometimes found to be deficient in vegans is vitamin D, which is vital for the functioning of almost all of our cells in the body. And it is very important for bone, heart, immune, and muscle cells. It's very important for everything in the body. Now, vitamin D is found in animal products. It's also added to fortified foods, such as cereals and some types of orange juice. And it can be found in mushrooms, especially if you leave them out in the sunlight for about 20 minutes or in ultraviolet light. They actually produce this vitamin D. So, but the best way to get vitamin D is from sunshine, and you can get it at a UV index that is above 3. Now, you can check any weather app for this information. It will tell you if you have in your area a UV index above 3. Now, as for vegans who live above the longitude line of 35 degrees, during the winter months, you will not have any UVB radiation to produce vitamin D through skin exposure to the sun. And the darker your skin, the less vitamin D your body will produce. So with no animal product consumption, you will most certainly be deficient in this vitamin and therefore must take it in the form of supplementation. Now, you can check your levels for vitamin D through a simple blood test. I recommend doing this regularly, and low levels that are below 40 nanograms per milliliter are considered a deficiency. Now, in deficiency, I recommend taking about 2,000 international units of vitamin D per day. And when supplementing with vitamin D, I also recommend at times to take it with vitamin K2 three times a week, because vitamin D and K2 work together. Now, vitamin K2 is mainly found in animal products, in specific animal products, and in fermented foods that most people do not consume on a regular basis. And also, the use of antibiotics can contribute to K2 deficiency. So the next vitamin deficiency that is common among vegans is also omega-3 fatty acids. Now, this is especially found to be deficient in men rather than women who are vegans. Omega-3 essential fats need to be supplied by the diet, and they are necessary for strong bones. They're anti-inflammatory, and they are very, very important for neurological functioning. Now, rich sources of omega-3 fatty acids on a plant-based diet supply alpha-linoleic acid, or for short, ALA, which is then converted by the body in a few steps to the longer chain omega-3 fatty acids, which include the EPA, eicosapentaenoic acid, and DHA, docosahexaenoic acid. And food sources of ALA include walnuts, flax seeds, hemp seeds, chia seeds, lots of seeds, and Brussels sprouts. But certain eating habits can hinder the conversion of alpha-linoleic acid to the longer chain EPA and DHA, and these habits include a high intake of omega-6 fatty acids in comparison with omega-3 fatty acid consumption. Like if you're eating a lot of salad and you add a lot of vegetable oils to your salad, or if you're using a lot of vegetable oils in your cooking, then this imbalance of fatty acids may take place. Also, a deficiency of the nutritional cofactors involved in the conversion process. You want sufficient B vitamins, you want vitamin C and magnesium and zinc in your diet to have sufficient of these nutrients in your diet. Also, trans fats destroy the conversion enzyme, so a vegan diet rich in partially hydrogenated fats, like a person who eats a lot of donuts, cakes, pies, cookies, margarine foods, microwave popcorn, will have too little omega-3 fats in their diet. Also, too much alcohol will reduce the efficacy of the conversion enzymes. Now, the next nutrient that may be deficient in vegans, and this is mostly deficient in female vegans, is iron. Now, iron is not readily as absorbed from plant foods as it is from animal sources, because vitamin A helps in the absorption of iron, while calcium, which is very rich in plant foods, actually reduces iron absorption. But vitamin C helps iron absorption, and it is found in lots of plant-based foods. So what I suggest is, when you consume iron-rich plant-based foods, such as soya beans and soya bean products, legumes, seeds, nuts, and leafy green vegetables, then you want to consume them along with vitamin C-rich plant foods as well, including broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cauliflower, bell peppers, spinach, and other leafy greens, as well as potatoes, tomatoes, and winter squash. So, as you can see, and this vitamin is especially in women, is deficient in female vegans that get their periods on a regular basis. So it is good to supplement with this nutrient in the form of iron bisglycinate during your period. Now, as you can see, it is very easy to maintain health on a vegan diet with proper eating habits involving whole foods and with low or no processed foods and the right supplementations with the right nutrients. So I hope you liked the content of this video, and I hoped it helped. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel as well. And if you are interested in more health and nutritional content, please visit my website at www.gorilladiet.com. Thank you very much.